has been a lot of misunderstanding between the local government, the communities, and waste pickers, because there's been a stigma associated with waste picking, whereby when someone sees a waste picker, will see a poor person, will see a homeless person, will see somebody who they will always give a name of a scavenger, somebody scrambling for food scrap. So for the organization to exist, I think it gave all recognition and respect of the sector. And as an organization also, we have been engaging government at the national level, whereby there were policies which speaks specifically to waste pickers, which is the guidelines to integrate waste pickers within the waste management system. So as an organization, so far, we believed that waste pickers provided with a material recovery facility can work together, and whatever it's derived or whatever money is made out of what has been recovered in the process should be divided equally amongst the members. We are encouraging the model of worker cooperatives, whereby all the earnings are divided equally amongst those who worked for that period. Sometimes, when we engaged with the middlemen individually, it becomes a challenge. We have seen waste pickers working together, having a representative or somebody as a coordinator at the landfill, where they will negotiate prices with the buyers. We don't discriminate against race. We don't discriminate against religion. We don't discriminate against sex. We don't discriminate also against politics. That is why we believed that any form of waste picker organization should carry some principles of non-political alliance or any non-political discrimination, non-sexist organization. We build an organization that is inclusive.
Countries such as Argentina, Chile, Brazil, and Colombia have advanced organization of recyclers unions to defend their work. In Brazil, for example, approximately 600 cooperatives organized in the national movement of waste pickers are organized in most of Brazilian states. The Brazilian movement fights for their recognition as fundamental environmental agents. Socioeconomic inclusion of recyclers is one of their key battles, and we should consider that each recycler, which are around 800,000 in the country, return 1 to 3 tons of waste in the product to the production chain a year. The movement also works in popular projects that seek to highlight their culture and the role of recyclers and their families. They develop educational projects, popular culture, recreational activities, digital inclusion, among others. Recyclers are key actors of the waste, of the zero waste society we are working for.
As Africa, we're struggling with unemployment. As Africa, we are struggling with waste management. I think working with associations or working with organized informal sector could be an alternative solution to these challenges that we are facing in Africa. And providing also a new waste management system that is not there in Africa. Africa still sends mixed waste to the landfill. I think working with the informal sector could also create a system that will also separate the waste from the mainstream.